Good morning, boys and girls. How are you today? I just wanted to jump on and read you a story. Are you ready for story time? Okay, let's go. I'm gonna put on my glasses now, and this will help me to read. Okay, all right, here we go. This is my special glasses. Miss Wanita is going to read for you today. The mouse who ate bananas. The mouse who ate bananas. B bananas. B says b bananas. So let's see. This is the front of the book. This is the spine of the book, and this is the back of the book. And this is the title of the book. Who knows? What do we call the person who writes the story? Do you know? Did you say author? Yes, the author is the person who writes the story. And the author of this book is Keith Faulkner. And the illustrator, what does the illustrator do? Huh? Yes, the illustrator draws the pictures. So the illustrator's name is Rory Tiger or Tiger, depending on how they pronounce it. So here goes. The mouse who hates bananas. Thud! The banana landed right next to the mouse. Thanks, he called up to the monkeys. Delicious, said mouse, as he threw the empty banana peel over his left shoulder. Along the dusty path stamped elephant. Stump, stump, stump. His huge foot landed right on Mouse's banana peel. Uh-oh, what do you think is gonna happen now? Let's see. Whoa! His feet shot up in the air, and his huge bottom hit the hard ground with an enormous earth-shaking curl. Thud! So elephant got a huge, he fell. Oh my gracious. I think that must have hurt. Time for a nice cool dip, said Rhino as he trotted down the hill to the river. Trot, trot, trot. Suddenly, his foot landed on another one of Mouse's banana peels. Oh my. Let's see what happened. Ah, bellowed Rhino as he careened. Careened means to roll over down the hill like a runaway truck. Head first into a tree went poor Rhino. His gigantic horn speared the trunk with a care thunk. So his horn speared the trunk. Through the jungle bounded lion, his big bushy mane flying in the air. Bound, bound, bound. But what do you think happened next? What do you think happened next? Let's find out. Grrr, roared Lion as he cartwheeled across the jungle floor like an acrobat. He hit the ground face first on his shiny white pointy teeth with a crack. So what happened to Lion? Lion fell down. And what do you think happened to his shiny white teeth? Let's see. Giraffe threw back his head for a good gallop. Gallop, gallop, gallop. On the third gallop, yes, you're right again. His foot landed on a slippery, slimy banana peel. And what do you think happened to Giraffe? Shouted Giraffe as his long, slender, wobbly legs tied themselves into a knot. So this is poor Giraffe. Can you see it, boys and girls? He tripped and tumbled to the ground with a crunch. This is poor Giraffe. What a sorry sight all the animals were. They decided it was high time to talk to Mouse. Stop leaving banana peels all around the jungle, they demanded. You should look where you're going, laughed Mouse, scampering away. Scamper, scamper, scamper. But all of a sudden, so look at the animal's face. Are they happy or sad? Do you think that they're happy with Mouse? Let's find out what happens. Mouse landed on one of his own slippery banana peels. He flipped up into the air and did a double somersault and landed flat on his back with a crump. Oh my. So let's see what happened to Mouse. He fell on his own banana peel. So, what do you think, boys and girls? Is it okay to throw banana peels on the floor? What should we do with our garbage when we are finished eating? Should we just leave them about? Or should we put them in the garbage bin? See, banana peels are slippery, so we have to be careful with them. So next time you eat something or a banana or anything, make sure you put it in the garbage. Okay, boys and girls? Did you like my story? Yes, yes, yes. Did you like my story? Yes, yes, yes. Or maybe no. It's okay if you don't like the story. But I would like you to tell me what kind of stories you like. And then your mommy can put it up for you. And I will try to read those kinds of stories for you next time. But everybody likes different things. So it's okay Sometimes we have to listen to a story we don't like. But remember, what did this story teach us? To put our garbage where? In the garbage bin. Okay, boys and girls, bye.